Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Hey, now that you've learned and you're able to play those E minor tab notes smoothly, it's time to take that skill to the next level. Now remember, those tab notes are not scales. You don't use them to play long lead riffs. Nobody learns to play acoustic guitar so they can play lead. You use them to put wow factor into the songs you play on acoustic guitar. And so in this lesson, you're going to learn how to weave those notes together using three different combination of notes and three strumming patterns to create some really cool sounding riff transitions. Now remember, riff transitions are the key skill that you need to become the guitar player other guys want to be. So in this lesson, whenever you're finished with this lesson, I created a separate practice video for you that you can turn to. It's called the E minor tab notes backtracking video. Long name, but it's a cool video. I'm going to do the backtracking playing the E minor chords, and I'll change to the chords while you create your own riff transitions. It's going to be a really cool exercise for you to do, and I think you're really going to like it. So why do I keep going on like this? Get your pick, get your guitar, meet me in the studio. We're going to learn how to create some really cool E minor riff transitions. Okay, so to get started, let's take a look at this simple little six-note pattern that I put together for you to create your very first riff transition. Now remember, this pattern is just one of an endless number of combinations that you can weave together to create a riff using those E minor tab notes. Now this first riff transition, we're going to transition to an A minor. We're going to change from E minor to A minor. So if you look at that screen, you look at the tab on the screen, the very last note is an open 5, which is an A note. The A note is the bass note of the A minor chord, okay? So you want to make sure that the last note that you play is the bass note of the chord that you're getting ready to change to. Now, there is an exceptions to that, but for this transition, I want you to learn to use that bass note, okay, as you're getting ready to learn. You can actually use any note in that chord as the last note or the last sound, because what you're trying to do is create the intent of the chord. So you can play it like this. But for all purposes, for our training purposes, I just want you to play the bass note of the chord right now as you're learning, okay? So the A minor would be like this. I'll play that again for you. Okay. If we were to go to a C, that last note would not be an open 5, it would be 3/5, because that 3 is the bass note of your C chord. So that transition would sound like this. Okay. If you were to play a G, you would use the last note as the 3rd fret on the 6th. That's your G, the bass note in the G chord. So that transition would sound like this. What I'm trying to show you is that you can use those notes to change to any chord in the E minor key as long as the bass note, the last note, is your bass note of the chord you're changing to. Okay? Now let's try it with a strumming pattern. We use a nice, clean, easy, simple strumming pattern, just a down-up strumming pattern like this. Okay, and we'll strum it. The accent strumming that we're going to put in we're going to lift up our fingers. In this case, we're just going to go to the A minor on this first one. So I want to lift up my fingers from the E minor, just like that. Then when we change to the A minor, you'll lift those fingers up again from the A minor formation. Now look at my strumming hand. Look how smooth that is. Remember, your fingers are gliding over the ice, right? Like a skater on the ice, just gliding over that pick guard. And your strumming pattern is just a continuous smooth motion. Your fingers are making the accent. Now if I were to exaggerate that, I'm taking my hand completely off of the fretboard. To get to that E minor. That's why I'm trying to share with you how important it is to know that muscle memory where you can get right back into your chord. Okay, so let's try that again. Change. Okay, that's your pattern. Here's what you'll do. When you do the transition will be on the third and fourth count. So each chord has four counts like this. One, I'll start off. One, two, three, four, one, and two, and three, and four. One, two. Okay? So I'm going to pause right here, and I want you to practice just that one transition to the A minor. Then I'm going to come back, and we're going to transition to the C, D, and G. Okay, in this next transition, we're going to go from the E minor to a C, E minor to D, and E minor to G. Okay? And what we're going to do is each time you go to that chord, we're going to give it that accent strumming. You'll be lifting up a finger. For the C, what I usually do is just lift up my middle finger on a C. Now, you can lift up whatever fingers you want to get that sound. I usually just lift up my middle finger on it, on this C chord. Now, when I go to the D chord, what I'm doing is I'm taking off my middle finger there. Okay? And when I go to the G chord, I'll take both these fingers off that G. Okay, so let's go ahead and try that. And I'll put the chords up on the screen for you. We'll go E minor to C, back to E minor to D, back to E minor to G. Using that same transition, except for that last note, becomes the bass note of the chord we're changing to. Okay, and I'll set the metronome at 120 beats per minute, and that'll keep us in step together there, okay? So we'll go ahead and start here. One, two, three, four. Okay, so in this last transition, we're going to change things up a bit again. You know, those first two transitions that you play, those first two riffs, that we played them just plain. We played them without any zest. No hammer-ons, no pull-offs, no slides, and they sound just fine. And depending on the type of song that you're playing and the rhythm of the song, that may be all you need. But a lot of times you can start adding pull-offs and slides and hammer-ons, and those riffs just come to life. So in this transition, I want to show you how to use a little slide in there to really make this transition sound cool. So here's what you're going to do. So we'll change from an A minor, then we'll go back to E minor, we'll change to a C, and we'll change to a D. Okay? So let's go ahead and try that. I'm not going to use the metronome on this. We'll just kind of play it a little bit slower than what I just showed you, but we'll do one, two. What I'm doing on that to get that accent on that A minor, I'm lifting those fingers up again, right? So here we go. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Here we go. And Okay, so go ahead and practice those riffs and be able to change it to each one of the chords in the key of E minor. And once you're able to do that nice and smooth, then go to my backtracking video, my practice video, and I'll be waiting for you in there, and I'll be playing some chords. And once you're in there, you'll be able to create your own riff transition. That's going to be a lot of fun for you. So go ahead and start practicing this riff. Get it down to where you're smooth with all of the chords, and I'll see you in the backtracking video.